Hi, I'm Pastor Kerrene of Today's Christian Woman. I'm here with fellow WIGNTV host of the Barbara Dean Show, Barbara Dean Franklin. How are you?
I am wonderful, Pastor. It is so good to sit with you again.
It's my pleasure. You have on there the WIGNTV website. Let's show that.
This is the WIGNTV network, Women's Internet Gospel TV Net to our mature audience, and the WIGN network to our young folk. I just like to say that because I want to include the young people. I want to make sure that they look at this network because we have something for everybody.
That we do. And for those who don't want to go to the website, we're right there on Facebook. So look up WIGNTV and you will find everything that you need to know, and we'll direct you to the website anyway. And you just have to click on anything that you're interested in. Barbara, we're going to talk a little bit about what's going on with the network and what we are trying to do and what we're all about.
Okay.
So let's look at some of the topics that we're going to be talking about that's coming up, and hopefully that we'll have a roundhouse discussion. Let me inform you that we are, in case people don't know, we are growing,
right,
and we will have new hosts that will be coming into the network that are going to open up new slots and take over some slots that weren't being fulfilled.
Yes.
So we're moving on. But one of the big things that people are talking about and women of all ages are getting involved in happens to be internet dating.
Internet dating. Ah, okay.
Should be interesting.
Truly, truly, truly.
What do you think?
Well,
good thing, bad.
I can go back to, and I'm really not big on internet dating. I have, put my hand in the fire a little bit, you know. I won't call any of the websites, but people can be whoever they want to be on the internet. I find that a lot of times people are not true about who they are. But it reminds me of a time when I was very young, and we used to have the chat lines, and I forget what they were called, but it was like a telephone. You know, you dial into this number, and it would be so many people on the line, and you would, talk to people. And I remember talking to this guy, and I think I was talking to this guy for a long time. I probably was about 15 or 16, and, you know, he was like 5'9". He was, just this chocolate brother. Oh, he was just so good looking on the telephone. But then one day he came over to the house, and he was like 4'11" and about, 320 pounds. So I'm not real good on the internet dating thing. You know, I think that it's possible. I do know people who have dated on the internet and, found success in that.
Mm-hmm.
One of those things that I don't think it would be for me. But I do know that if I were to be on the internet with someone, it would have to be someone referred me, hey, like you talk to my friend, and maybe he's in California.
Sure.
You know him, and we're just kind of communicating back and forth online because somebody has referred to me, vouched for that person, and vouched for me as well. So I'm good with that. But as far as I have friends who have tried it, personal friends that I know that, have been on those internet dating sites, and they have not found success yet, so.
I think it's a great way to take your money,
mm-hmm.
but obviously it works for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. They say one out of every five person finds their mate online nowadays. Being a sociologist, I had to go and check those statistics.
Right.
Oh, they have statistics right up my line. Let's check and see what they're about. And they've actually underscored themselves. It's actually two out of every five that find their mate online. But I've talked to a couple of them, and they've gone through a lot of money trying to find that one person. Ooh. And they get individuals that they really don't have much in common with.
Right.
And you're absolutely right about the pictures thing. And that's why I always recommend, show me a video. Give me a video. Hold up today's paper so I know you're not lying
to me.
And because I've tried this, and the response was, well, don't you trust people? I said, not so much.
Exactly.
Not so much.
You know, it's really funny because it brings to mind, and a couple of years ago, I signed up for an internet dating, and they matched you with people. Mm-hmm. And it was so funny that they matched me with somebody that I worked with, and I never said anything to them. And I said, if they matched me with him, I wonder if they, you know, matched him with me. So was he looking at me every time he saw me and said, uh-huh, she's on that dating website as well. And we never, ever said anything to each other. I did share it with a girlfriend of mine. She was like, oh, he's nice. You ought to go ahead and talk to him. And I was like, nah, you know, I really think I want to date, but sometimes I don't think I really want to date, you know, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I was just like kind of, you know, taken aback, like, nah, I don't think I'm going to do that. And definitely, I found that anytime Barbara Dean Franklin initiates a relationship, mm-hmm. it never works. You know?
So don't bother with that,
exactly,
doing it on your own.
Exactly.
So no. You will believe in praying for your spouse?
Well,
I mean, if you're interested.
Yes, I truly have been praying, trusting God, but somebody gave me something that was really profound, that, like, stop praying and just wait on him, you know. And so I've already told God what it is that I want, and, you know, God does not need my help. Mm-hmm. So I'm just waiting and trusting and believing. I'm happy where I am. I'm good, you know, being right here. And, you know, when God is ready to bless me with a mate, I'm confident that, you know, wherever, you know, however, you know, God will bring him into my life. So I'm just waiting. I'm in a holding pattern. I'm on the runway. You know, I'm probably next in line, you know, but I'm waiting.
Next in line.
Exactly. I'm waiting. Right.
Someone keeps buzzing me on my phone, but we're going to continue on. Mm-hmm. Please keep talking, because it's the church that's doing this, so I need to respond right quick.
Okay,
but go right ahead.
That is no problem. Yes. Yeah, so as far as the internet dating goes, again, I have friends that they want to be in a relationship, and I think I kind of talked about this when I sat with you know, Jay Danzy, that women want men that are emotionally attached to them, and I think that when it comes to internet dating, again, people are not always honest, and sometimes people just have hidden agendas. You know, people are not truthful today. You know, we're not really open and honest with each other the way that we should be. You know, me, I'm, you know, what you see is what you get, you know, with me. I'm very honest. I'm very open. Sometimes I'm probably so truthful and honest to a fault, you know.
Sure.
But that is who I am, and that's the way I want people to be with me. But I find that people just, They don't even know how to be, you know, real and honest with other people. So the internet dating thing, the changing my status to an open relationship, you know, all those things, I'm kind of old school, you know. Again, when I was on here, I said I talked to a guy and I said I wanted to be courted, you know. And,
sure.
You know, he still hasn't called me back. So I'm good with that. Again, God is courting me. I know what I want. You know, I know who I am. I know whose I am. And I'm just so having such a good time being Barbara Dean Franklin right now, you know. So I'm just going to let God continue to do what he's doing in my life.
Obviously, it's important because we're made to have that relationship.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And there are steps that we can do to ensure that that happens. So we're not saying that you can't do this.
Right.
We're not saying that it's a bad ideal. Mm-hmm. I think it's a great ideal to meet people and to meet individuals. And, you know, a lot of people say, well, don't date until you're ready to get married. Mm-hmm. That's the same reason why they put their daughters in all-girls school. Okay. And I'm looking at this as, well, and I tell parents this all the time, and I tell young girls, young men this, this is the way that you learn to socialize and find out exactly what you honestly want and what you can put up with.
Right.
Internet dating, it's probably a good idea if you go into it with the mindset, I may not find my mate, but I will find someone that's interesting and someone that maybe I can become friends, and who knows, maybe his friend will become. You never know how it's going to work out. The ideal is that they're looking for compatibility. And there are Christian dating websites, certainly Christian Mingle. Someone brought to my attention that there's actually a free Christian online dating, and it's really free.
Okay.
Now, the only way I knew this was to set up a profile to make sure they didn't ask me.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I lied on the profile. It's not true.
Okay.
And I took it down.
Okay.
I did take it down.
All right.
But I needed to know before I recommended it to anyone whether this was something that worked. To make sure that it did work, I didn't put up any pictures.
All right.
I put up no pictures. And I wanted to see if just my personality would be enough. Mm-hmm. And I had some hits on that. That was true. My personality was true.
Okay.
But looking at their pictures, I'm thinking, not so much.
Exactly.
Not so much. And their personalities?
You know.
Definitely not.
I can, I just remember, again, meeting... Okay, the internet dating, talking to somebody, and you know they, love you so much real soon. Okay, and then I'll never forget. I was talking to this guy. He sent his picture. Oh, I'm talking about brother was fine. You know, he was somewhere. You know, of a different nationality. Didn't speak. it's funny. But anyway, he. His name was Clifford, and I would never forget. And then one day.
I guess not.
Okay. One day, Clifford said, oh, you know, my mom, you know, she's in the hospital. You know, I need money. You know, I said, I hope she don't die. Because Clifford.
I'm praying for
okay,
you.
Exactly. Because I cannot help you, brother. You know, if you think, you know. And so what I found out is that a lot of people, you know, were sitting in these internet chat rooms. You
sure.
know, you have a lot of women that are really, they are lonely. I'll just say that, you know. Mm-hmm. And they will, you know, fall for anything, you know. But, you know, I'm, again, I always say I'm an OG, you know, because really, I've been in the world, you understand, and I don't, you know, really get into that. But it was just really funny how he just, you know, just spoon-fed me everything that he thought that I needed to know. And
yes.
if I was not confident in who I was, you know, I probably would have wrote a check. At the time, the check would have been bad because I didn't have any money. But, you know... you have to be very careful.
You do. And that goes for these well-known popular sites. Mm-hmm. They do what they can, mm-hmm. but not everyone on there is honest.
Exactly.
And I actually heard that, and this woman was saying, I can't wait to meet him. I can't wait to meet him. But she had to pay for the ticket to get there.
Wow.
And I said, well, that's probably not a good
exactly.
idea. And she was saying, but he loves me. He loves me. I said, ask him these questions.
Right.
Turned out the guy who said he was living in California mm-hmm. was actually African, living in Africa, and he just wanted her to send the money so he could buy the ticket.
Exactly.
Ladies, think.
Please.
Use your head.
Please.
Certain things that are Americana mm-hmm. that we just know. We know who Michael Jordan is.
Right.
We know about his commercials.
Mm-hmm.
Use a phrase from the commercial. That's a very easy thing to do. Use a phrase from the commercial. Mm-hmm. Or for something that is popular culture,
right.
they don't know the answer.
Exactly.
If they don't know the answer, they're not American. Use your heads.
Think about it.
If anyone ever asks you for money, don't be so
turn off, number
open-hearted.
One.
And any guy that asks you for money, American or not,
true.
Say goodbye.
Exactly.
Because that's not right. A real man isn't looking for your cash.
Exactly.
He's looking for your heart.
Exactly.
And yes. the way to the heart, not your stomach, ladies, but it's actually through Christ.
Most definitely.
That's the best way. It should be the best way to get to your heart. And oddly enough, there are some people on the internet, and I want you to understand there are people on the internet, on the dating sites, that will say, I'm a Christian, and I believe, and I love the Lord.
True.
And then he wants to see you without your top.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. Say
no.
not Christian.
No. There's something that's not right about
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
And whereas we look at things that we're not sure of what's going on. If you're not sure, then just ignore it.
Exactly.
That's the best thing that I have for internet dating.
Right, right.
If it doesn't add up, and use your head. Don't just go in with your heart. Use your head.
Right.
And you'll be all right.
And I truly believe that in anything, all things take time.
Sure.
So if it's meant to be, take your time. find out, do some research, be able to verify the things that are being mm-hmm. said to you. Don't just take it at face value. Don't take that picture. You know, look through the magazines, because if he's so fine, usually he's in Essence or he's in another magazine.
He's somewhere.
That's all I got before, you know. Yeah, so, you know, so yeah, just take your time and be very, very careful about, you know, what it is that you're doing.
Another thing, if it looks like it's a professional picture, mm-hmm. it's not him.
Exactly.
It's just not him.
Oh, Clifford.
He probably watched Bill Cosby.
It's something.
We were talking not long ago, just mm-hmm. a few hours ago, mm-hmm. about food.
Right.
Cooking.
Yes. Because, you know, I'm not one of those salad-eating chicks. You could tell that, you know, I like to eat.
Which is a good thing, because you die if you don't.
I know, that's right.
What's your favorite food?
Anything cooked. Anything cooked. I really, I'm kind of, I tell this, you know, I'm doing Weight Watchers, right? And mm-hmm. so I'm not sweets. I don't do the sweets. I'm a meat and potatoes girl, you know. Get me a steak, you know, well done.
Yeah.
And a baked potato. I'm real good. Piece of bread. Oh, you really got me there. I'm hungry, too.
Ready to go.
Exactly.
Cut, we're done.
Exactly.
One of the things, and I've determined, and I told my older sisters, because we go to the DIA a lot, Detroit Institute of Arts, mm-hmm. and we go, and we start up high, and we go to the second floor where they have all the old time and what they ate in that period. Mm. And we get to the table where all this food is set up. Mm. And we're just like drooling, thinking, okay, let's go.
I know.
And we never see the whole museum because we stop at that stupid table every time and realize, I'm hungry.
Okay.
Let's go.
All right.
But what do you think about having a cooking show on WIGN?
I think that would be really nice. I think as you say that, I'm thinking like, you know, the Chef Ramsay show, where you have different people maybe cooking, competing all at the same time, you know, mm-hmm. to, you know, to determine who would be the person that, you know, becomes the cook on WIGN. So it's a competition.
That's very good.
Yeah, you know, yeah. So don't just do one person and bring them in, but bring several people, let them cook, you know, for a period of time, mm-hmm. and then the winner becomes the, you know, the person who has a cooking show.
And you and I get to judge.
Oh, most definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. We know good that food.
Yes, I think I would be a great judge. They have to be good cooks, though. Okay, so yeah. Do not even try to audition if you really don't know how. I don't want the bologna sandwich with the red ring around it, you know, where, that comes up in the middle, right, you know, slap it on the bread. No, we need some real food. Yes,
I'm looking for a nice
presentation.
Prime rib.
Yes.
It has to look good.
Yes.
If it looks good on the plate, because women are visual.
Right, very.
And if it doesn't look good, mm-hmm. we're like, mm-mm. No, thank you.
Seasoned just right.
Yeah. Mm-mm.
Really
not
cut.
Too much.
Like,
not
really,
too much.
Really cut. Let's go.
Yeah.
For real.
And I am very particular about my steaks.
Okay.
It has to be done just right. Mm. I don't want a lot of seasoning on it.
Okay.
I want it seasoned properly. Mm. And I don't want to have to put anything on it except butter.
Okay.
Mm. Give me butter on that and I'm ready to go.
All right, butter, baby. Let's
butter makes everything good.
Exactly.
Makes everything good. It's kind of like bacon.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out right now, how can I do a cupcake with bacon inside of it? That would be perfect.
Mm-mm. I gave up bacon for Lent. I could not wait until it was over. I mean, I've never craved anything. So, and what's really funny, because now I'm doing Weight Watchers. I hate to keep, you know, plugging Weight Watchers, but I really haven't had any bacon, you know.
Oh, you poor thing.
Yes, exactly. I did have some the other day. I went out with my friend Bo Dillon, Bo Dillon Bowties. You know, he's a really good friend of mine. He made some ties for my pastor. And we went to a restaurant, and I did have some bacon, and I had it. But usually I was a bacon and egg person every day, and I find myself, I've only had bacon probably about twice since the Lenten season has been over.
Really?
So.
It's something that I eat one meal a day, not because I'm dieting. I probably should, but
hold on, because
bacon.
Weight Watcher says dieting, the first three letters of dieting are die, so you don't want to diet, okay? You want to just eat different.
Eat different.
Right.
That's not going to work for me.
Okay.
That's not going to work for me. My sister has gone on Weight Watchers mm-hmm. and medical weight loss and all of that, and mm-hmm. I just said, well, you know what? I'm going to eat whatever I want.
Exactly.
That stuff that you have,
mm-hmm.
I don't like that. So going to eat that.
Yeah, I know that's
so
right.
that would be horrible. So what I've decided to do, and my form of exercise is, I picked up Zumba lessons.
Okay.
Yeah. On my Connect. I have Connect, so I'm in the basement
now. Right.
Trying to get this in. The one thing I've confirmed is that my family has no rhythm.
Oh. So
there's a myth that's destroyed because we just don't do it.
And
I'm tripping over myself, but I'm down there trying to do it. And as of yesterday, I said, you know what, Kerrene? You need to stick to boxing.
I know. I see your bag in the back saying you could do that.
Yeah, I can
no
do
rhythm
that.
For boxing.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. I don't need rhythm for that. I can just hit something and move around and duck.
I really want to do Zumba, but I think it's, I have everything. We were just talking yesterday. Somebody said, you have a gym really in your basement, you know, because I have the stationary, I have the Zumba, I have the Turbo Jam, I have the hula hoop, I have the shake weight. You know, I have it all. I have it. My stationary bike is full of clothes, you know. the hula hoop is over, you know. I put the toilet paper in the paper towel in it so it can, I can find it, you know. So anyway, I got to get better at that. I am going to get better. But the cooking show, I think, will be an excellent idea. I think
I like your idea. That we get
generate,
other people. So here's what you need to do, ladies, or gentlemen that happen to be watching. You need to put on the page, hold up that page again.
Okay, all right, okay. Let's
or see. The Facebook page of WIGNTV.net. That's that. Or go to the Facebook page, which I can't go back to because I'm not that smart.
Well,
no, I'm kidding. go to our page there and look us up. Oh, I have several messages here.
In demand.
Yeah. That's kind of like saying, Pastor, hurry up. We need you now. But go to the Facebook page of WIGNTV and just drop a line. Say, I would like to try out for the cooking show. Leave your information there, and I guarantee you, we will get back in touch with you. Now, if you don't do that, if we don't get enough of you to do that, then we'll have to pick someone ourselves, and that means Barbara and I won't get a chance to eat, and we won't like that because we kind of want to do that
really, really bad.
Exactly.
So. My daughter wanted, we were talking the other day, she was cooking something, and she cooks and she chops up the bell peppers, the red, the yellow, the green. I mean, and her food is always so pretty. And she was like, Mom, you know, I said, well, baby, go back to school, you know, to cook. And she was like, I don't want to. I don't think I just want to be in the kitchen all the time.
Sure.
I said, well, baby, own the restaurant. You know, you don't necessarily have to always do the cooking. You can, you know, take, you know, start off cooking, then find your restaurant, you know, then oversee, you know, your kitchen or do whatever it is that you want to do. So I think it's a great idea. I know a lot of people, you know, that really like to cook and cook very well, you know, and those people, you know, if you just want me to personally come over to your house and taste the meal, we can start off there to see if you, you know, even if you even want to attempt to come over here and do the show, you know, I'm available.
Yeah, and I'll join you.
Okay.
I'm good with that.
Exactly.
I know
available.
How to drive. We can do that.
I think that would be a great idea, though. I think that it would just generate so much synergy here, you know, in the city of Detroit. We are looking to, you know, that's what the station is doing, looking for positive things that are going on in Detroit. We are trying to be the change that we hope to see, you know, and to inspire people, motivate people to get up and, you know, do the things that need to be done in this great city to make a change today. So
definitely.
Yeah, I think that would be great.
Definitely. So we're looking for you, and give us something that is healthy, give us something that's not healthy. That's my favorite. Add in a dessert, do breakfast, lunch, or dinner. We don't really care.
Right.
As long as you can give us something that is perhaps on a budget, and then perhaps something that's off budget, because we like something that every
affordable.
Now and then that goes off, but we really need something that's affordable for the families as well.
Exactly.
All right,
okay.
So we're looking at that. Tell us, what's going on in the city of Detroit?
Okay, well, so there is so much that is going on in the city of Detroit. The one thing, you know, I'm a Facebooker, you know, that's kind of like my network, my ministry. I I'm involved in a lot of different groups or different things on Facebook. So what I like is women creating caring communities all over the world. My friend, her name is Mona Copeland, and hey, Mona, I hope you don't mind me talking about your, it's a network of women, and Mona is very involved in the union, mm-hmm. and so like the presidential, there's something that's happening this weekend. She's looking for people to volunteer to help with the, I want to say it's the presidential caucus or something that's going on. I can't find it right now, but women creating caring communities all over the world. If you go to that website, that page, you will find the information that you need. This weekend, well, like May the 19th, they have a Detroit Recreation Department is hosting an annual Detroit Kids Fishing Derby at Lake Francis. That's on May the 19th. Well, just yesterday they had the, I believe it was called Predators to Protectors, and that was with Yusuf Bunchy and Shaka Singor. I'm going to hope I didn't mess up his name, but these are two brothers that are out here doing things in the community. They used to be in the streets, and you know, now they're going mm-hmm. back, giving back to the streets, things that are going on. We have a There's Hope for Detroit page that they're always putting out good information and doing good things, like on the May the 4th, the NAACP, there's a job fair. So, you know, it takes a village all. There are just different things on Facebook that are giving out a lot of good information about mm-hmm. things that are going on in the city. So many people talk about Detroit in a negative way. Sure. There are so many great things that are going on in the city of Detroit. A lot of times you don't know what you know until you know it. And so we just need to continue to put the word out there. And, you know, that's our hope, is that, again, we create that synergy, that we all get together sure. and share the information and talk about what's going on, and everybody show up, because that is the way this city is going to come back. It's going to be with ideas that are different, you know, ideas that are being shared. And one day, you know, somebody's just going to whisper that one thing out there, and people are going to grab onto it. And the city is coming back. We definitely are.
There's so many people keep counting Detroit down. They mm-hmm. have throughout the years. Mm-hmm. And it, when I first moved to San Diego, someone said, they asked me where I was from. I said, well, originally I'm from Detroit, right. Michigan. And they said, oh, wow, you're lucky that you got out of there alive. And I, what are you talking about? Mm-hmm. Say, well, that's a rough city. It's all ghetto and it's all burnt down. And I said, well, I never lived there in that kind of condition. But more importantly, Detroiters are fighters. Right. They're believers in their community. They stick together and they will always rebound. So whatever's going on, and some very good things have always come out of the city. Mm-hmm. We need to remember that. The events that you mentioned that are coming up, right. you can find that right on Barbara's page.
Right.
All that will be listed, so look for Barbara Dean Franklin on Facebook. Make her your friend. She's a nice person.
Exactly, yeah. I am.
One of the things that you don't know about that is happening for Mother's Day weekend, so if you want to take your mom out, the founder, Anita West Calloway, suggests that you take her out to McDonald's. Don't do that. No, don't do that to mom. Take her out someplace decent.
Exactly.
But Glory Bound Productions, they, in 2007, 2008, they had the production of I Wish I Had Been Ready, which was done at the Music Hall and several other theaters around the city, and they toured the country. Well, they're back with a new play. I wish I could remember the name of it. But it's going to be at Faith Community Church, which is on Otter Drive in Melvindale, Michigan. That's something that is going to be really good. I've been told that it is better than I Wish I Had Been Ready, which was a phenomenal play.
Okay.
This one is set between, I can give you a little information about it. What do you do and if you have one foot living in the church and all right. the other foot straggling in the world.
Okay.
You're set between two worlds, basically.
All right.
So which way are you going to go? This is a decision that everyone makes
right.
each and every day of their life. Which way are you going to go?
Mm-hmm.
we always have that choice. We choose to be saved. Mm-hmm. And there's a reason why that we pick up our cross daily,
right,
because it's our choice. When we look at having one foot in the world, well, we don't do that as saved people. Mm-hmm. But when we are faced with decisions to be made, mm-hmm, too often we look to what we believe to be right. We look at what we desire, and we leave out the godly part. And that's the same thing as having one foot in, mm-hmm, and one foot out. Mm-hmm. All decisions should be made with God. So in that sense, I can relate to it, because every day we're going to make some kind of decision, whether it's what we're going to wear, what we're going to eat, are we going to do that exercise, what job we're going to take, whether we're going to be on time to that job. These are decisions.
Exactly. But when you say that, Pastor, you know, because I... you know, I'm being ordained on May the 20th as a deacon in my church,
yes,
Greater Southern Missionary Baptist Church. You know, I always do that 8,000 Fullerton. I can't help it. I love
nice
my church.
Plug.
Okay, exactly. I love my church. But, you know, for the people that are out there struggling, you know, with, you know, do I have one foot in or, you know, one foot out? You know, they talk about, when I was talking with my friend the other day, he was talking about living in the Old Testament or living under the new, you know, mm-hmm, under the law or under grace, you know. I think, and I said this before, that a lot of times people don't want to go to the church because we kind of make it so hard. You know, they think that living is so hard,
sure,
you know, when you're in the church. But like you say, you pick up your cross daily, you know. I don't know if anybody's ever going to be sinless, you know, but again, you know, we should be sinning less than we did, you know, when we started off. But I really would like to, if you get information on that, because I definitely would like to, you
definitely
know, see that. I would like to see how they present that play, you know, mm-hmm, what is the bottom line, what is the outcome of it at the end of the play, at the end of the day,
sure,
you know, what is the message that, you know, comes across. Because me, myself, personally, I love the Lord, you know, and again, I'm never perfect, but I know I told you from the very beginning, that love thing, you know, I do have that. I can do that very well. But there are sometimes, you know, even me, you know, I'm struggling, you know, even if I don't sin outwardly, you know, here, you know, you think about things. And so, you know, you've got to ask forgiveness every day. Every day I have to, you know, pray and ask God to forgive me for something.
Well, that's the thing. You can't stop the thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
You can't stop those.
Mm-hmm.
It's when we dwell on those thoughts,
okay,
that they become sin. They take root and they fester.
Okay.
Satan can bring anything into your mind.
Mm-hmm.
And that's his job. He
right.
does that, and he's
okay.
good at doing that. But when we sit there and we say, well, you know, that kind of makes sense,
mm-hmm,
or that's not a bad idea,
okay,
and we know that it's not godly.
Sure.
We
True.
Know that.
Right, right, right.
But we allow that to fester.
Mm-hmm.
That's when sin manifests itself.
Okay.
But as far as being able to stop, the thoughts are there, but mm-hmm, do you have to entertain them?
Exactly.
Hey, take a seat. Let's look and see what we've got going on there. Want a
Let's
cup of coffee?
It. Right, right.
Yeah.
Let's talk about it.
No. It's kind of like when Jesus was out in the wilderness and he had done that fasting.
Mm-hmm.
Satan came and bought the suggestions, but at every suggestion, he didn't entertain them. He
didn't say,
you may have a point.
Right.
No, instead, he used the scripture and said, mm-hmm, no, this is the way it really is.
Right.
You can't stop the thought.
Mm-hmm.
It's there. You don't have to keep it in your head.
All right.
Just let go of the thought.
Okay.
The problem that we run into is that we start thinking, it's not a bad idea. It sounds pretty good.
How
I wonder why I didn't
that?
Think
yeah.
that. And that's when we run into sin.
Right. Okay.
So
okay.
Let's not give him too much power.
Exactly.
One of the things that I teach my church, and this is the sociologist in me.
Okay.
Sociology 101.
Right.
First thing that we learn. A has no more power over B than what B allows A to have.
Okay.
We translate it spiritually. Satan has no more power over you than what you allow him to have.
Right, right.
Don't give him the power.
Wow.
Just don't give it to him.
I was just sitting here with a young lady on Facebook who was going through some things, and it kind of really was the message that I told. You have it is within you to either figure out you're going to have a bad day, or it's up to you to figure out if you're going to have a good day,
mm-hmm,
you know. So good advice. Thank you. Like I told you when I walked in here, every time you open your mouth, I learn something from you, and I just thank God for that.
Well, I thank God for it as well. And what you're saying is quite true. What you gave your friend the advice, God gave us free will.
Right.
We decide whether we're going to live righteously or unrighteously. We decide whether each day is going to be a good day or a bad day.
That's so
Things
true.
Come in life.
Mm-hmm.
That's life.
Yes.
We're going to run into difficulties. We're going to have problems. There are things that we're not going to enjoy.
Yes.
Life throws us some big curves.
Mm-hmm.
Do we have to fall down in it?
Right.
No. It's all in how you do it. That's one of the things that I love about Hezekiah.
Mm-hmm.
Hear the troops coming in.
Right.
Let's come on, man. We're going to get them. And they send them a little, the king sends them a little note and says, "Dear Hezekiah, how you doing, dude?
Okay.
I'm outside, coming in, going to kill you, going to kill the family, going to kill everyone inside, going to rob and pillage and all that. And P.S., there's nothing your God can do.
Okay.
Love you.
All right.
And Hezekiah says, wow.
Lord.
And does he fall down with it? Mm. That's a bad day.
That's a very bad day.
Hezekiah takes the letter and goes into the temple and says, Lord, see what he said?
Mm.
He said this about you. He said this, you can't keep your people.
And what are you going to do?
What you going to do? And he leaves it there.
Mm.
Love it.
Mm.
Absolutely. Mm. Love that. If we can get to that point, then our days, even at their worst, aren't so bad.
Yes.
Because we know, all I have to do is take it to God. God, here's what's happening in my life. This really sucks. I am really upset about this. This is destroying all
Thank
of my
you.
Plans, but I'm your kid. What you going to do about this?
If we could just leave it there. That's the key. Just leave it with the Lord. He does not need our help. But
no. And it all goes back to, do we trust him?
Mm-hmm.
We have faith, but do we trust him?
Right. Right.
You have to trust them.
Okay, Pastor, I don't want to shout, but you know, that was a good word right there.
Let's get back to this in the city of Detroit.
Yes.
We were talking about Glory Bound Productions. This is a poster of their last show, I Wish I Had Been Ready. The writer, the producer, and the casting director is Anita West Calloway, native Detroit woman being heard around the world. Her next production, Glory Bound Production, is going to be at Faith Community Church. And I told her, why are you stepping down? And she said, shut up. But it's going to be a marvelous thing. That's on West Otter Drive in Melvindale, Michigan. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be the Saturday of Mother's Day weekend. So that will be May 12th. Again, even though she said take your mother to McDonald's, don't you dare do that. Mom deserves a lot more than McDonald's. So if kids are watching this, Mom, if you're watching this and you're wondering, my kids never do anything nice for them, then steer them toward this, because even though I haven't seen this production because it's not out yet, I can assure you it will certainly bless your soul and your young people, your teens, your younger people, they need to be there for it, because I promise you, there will be a word in them in this play for them, and it will be well done. And it's not something that, it's full of church stuff. Not exactly.
Okay.
It's going to be a lot more than that, because she is a little bit on the edge, but it always has a very strong spiritual meaning. And if we're honest with one another and honest with God, we don't live in heaven.
Right.
We live right here on earth,
yes,
and there are things that we know that's happening. So,
are we going to post that on our on the
WIGN?
We
are going to post it on the website on
WIGNTV.net.
Thank you. I talk so much, I can't get it all out.
Yes.
We're going to do more of these kinds of things. And again, look for new hosts, new shows that are coming out right here on WIGNTV.net. They're sure to bless you. Don't forget the cooking show.
Right.
We are excited about it.
Yes,
you need to line up and let us know. Your family keeps telling you you can cook. Here's your chance to prove that.
Exactly.
Just feed us.
Exactly.
Just feed us
till we won't know more.
There you go. And we will be happy.
Yes, yes.
Barbara, what do you have to say?
Well, again, I'm excited about the opportunity to sit on WIGNTV.net. I thank you. I thank Isaac for allowing me to have a show. I know this show is not about me, Barbara Dean Franklin, but it is about the masses that the information will get to. Somebody needs to know that we all go through something in life. Somebody needs to know that they need to see real people who have overcome some things, you know, and I've overcome some things, and I want to help some people come over. You know, I want them to know that, you know, they're not alone. Things that are happening, nothing new is under the sun, you know, that somebody else has already gone through it. We have a network of women who are here willing to help. You know, we have a resources that we are willing to do whatever we can to make some changes in your life. So changes in this city, that is the, you know, this is a change network, you know, and we're looking for to be able to bless people, you know, just with the information, just showing up every week, you know. If you show up and, you know, maybe we're the only Bible you may ever read, you know, maybe we're the only light that you will see that shines, you know, the light is going to shine on this network. You know, Amen. The hand of God is on this network. And so we want to be a blessing to others. We, you know, it is not about us, but it is about you, the people that tune in every week to look at this information, the people that are out there that are struggling with something. We love you. We want to be a blessing to you. And the only way that we do that is because we don't know what you're going through unless you share that information with us. So if you're going through something and you really want some help, you really want people to love on you, to talk to you, to be there for you, to understand you, then you need to tune in to WIGNTV.net.
Very good. I can't say anything more following that. We're here for the whole person. So tune in and be blessed. Until we meet again, may God bless you and keep living saved.